Hi everyone, this is Anjali. I'm a first year MBA student of VITBS, and today we're going to talk with our MBA coordinator of VITBS, MBA, Dr. Uma Jaydev. So let's start, ma'am. As we know that you have been in the admission process, so I would just like to know that what kind of potential and what skills you are seeing so that at least you are going to transfer as a candidate for MBA may help. What skills you are looking at then?
Hello everyone, and it's good to be on this platform and share some information about VIT with the school. For potential candidates who are looking at taking admissions in VIT with the school, we have a rigorous selection process, and like any of the top-ranked business schools, the procedures are the same, that they have to have a valid good score, that is the admission test score. And based on that, they apply with their academic records and other documents. The candidates are shortlisted and then they will be called for a written test and a personal interview. Now, there is a slight departure from the selection processes that are practiced in other schools when we compare ourselves with other business schools. One is that we are not conducting group discussions, but rather a written ability test. So in this written ability test, what we are looking at is candidates' written communication skills in building an argument and debating about a general topic of interest, wherein we expect them to take a position for or against and argue for whatever stand that they are taking. So through this, what we would be assessing is, one, obviously their written communication skills, their capacity to build, argue, think, clarity of thought, expression, articulation, and many such aspects related to communication. This is what we are going to majorly look at during the selection process. So this is something which is different from most of the business schools. Apart from this written ability test, we also have a personal interview that is conducted by a panel of faculty members. So during personal interview, we are going to assess the oral communication skills of the student. And during this time, we are obviously going to look at what kind of knowledge they possess about general business environment in the country, whether they are suited to do an MBA program, whether they take the rigor of an MBA program, and will they be able to successfully graduate as MBA graduates. That's what we are looking at. So they have to pay attention to these aspects.
It was really helpful, ma'am, what you said. Now coming to the second question, what I would ask is, with the current students, the current MBA students, what skill sets, what improvement you need, what you look at, how they are working, what else improvement and what extra you would want from them?
So what I'm going to now share is not just for current students, it is for potential students as well. As far as VIT Business School is concerned, we are a mission-driven school, which means we are very dedicated to, in letter and spirit, to our mission. And our mission is to develop innovative, globally competitive, and socially responsible leaders. This is the mission that we are looking at. So if you look at our curriculum and our program structure, and the program learning objectives, all are in tune with this particular mission, that you know, students should be able to innovate, students should be able to compete on a global scale within their countries because they will be like, working in multicultural environments, and they should also be ethical leaders who have sensitivity towards the society that they are working in. So these are the major, goals that we are looking at. When they graduate, they should possess these skills. So as far as our MBA students are concerned, we are definitely looking at that they should be having the skills to solve problems, they should have analytical skills, they should be able to think logically, and these things get developed when they are not passive learners but active learners. So what we are essentially talking about is learning by doing, learning by practicing. So we are we expect that they will do a lot of projects, and then and do these projects as members of the team, collaborate with each other, and then learn collaboratively. So this is what we are looking at it, and we hope to give an atmosphere which is congenial to this kind of learning. That is what we are looking at.
Okay, now third I would just like to ask is, as we know that focus is moving towards digitalization, and in our VITBS also it's digital classrooms as well as exams. We have exam pad, DG exam pads on which exams are taken. So I would just like to ask you, ma'am, where do you think that this teaching learning process is moving towards? Is the classroom going to be shifted towards the experimental, and as many classrooms have already shifted towards digitizing? So what's your opinion?
Yes, we are very committed to digitalizing the entire school, and we are the first school in the entire university to go fully digital. And to take this further, what we are now planning is to turn our classrooms into flipped classrooms. So what we mean by flipped classrooms is that the conventional learning that happens in class through lectures and other things will happen prior to the class, where, like, you know, virtual learning, online learning will happen. And traditionally what the students used to do as assignments and exercises back at home or in hostels will now be done in classrooms. So classrooms will be more of application of the knowledge that they learn prior to class, and then in classrooms we are talking about applying the knowledge that they already have acquired. So this is what we are working towards, and we hope to be successful in that.
So now I'm just talking about VITBS students. What, according to you, are the challenges which we will be facing after we graduate from here when we are going to set our careers? So what challenges and what things we have to keep in mind?
Okay. I think anybody would agree with me if I say that when you step out of your learning environment and go into the practical world, learning never stops. So students should have this culture wherein that they are continuously going to learn and then keep honing their skills. That is one aspect that we really need to work upon. The other thing is, students may possess knowledge and skills, but also the right attitude is what is going to set them apart from others in the team or their peers or colleagues or whatever it is. So having positive attitude is very important, and also function in multicultural environment where people from diverse backgrounds are going to be working with you. So we need to respect people who are working with us, have sensitivity to people coming from diverse backgrounds and culture, and at the same time be very ethical. So these are all things which we need to inculcate in us, and all the rest of the things will follow. So we need to be learners, be strong in our ethics, and also respect others and be team players. These are things that we already know. So I just like to emphasize, this is what is going to actually, you know, win the day.
So ma'am, I would like to ask, other than studies, what else you would think that a student should have knowledge about? Extracurricular, what extra?
Okay, apart from studies, generally we see that, you know, the tendency to read extra is slowly coming down. And but in the long run, it really helps a lot to have general awareness about things that are happening around you. What impacts the business and the society, that is very important. Therefore, students should, graduates should develop this ability to read a lot, and then know about the Indian business environment, global business environment, a sense of economy as to how it is performing, doing, and then of course, like, you know, some knowledge about, like, you know, what is happening in the political front, how is it going to affect business, and what is happening in the society in general, current affairs, gender awareness. These are things that anybody should, like, you know, be keeping track of. So reading good, other general material, like, you know, newspapers, magazines, these are things that students are not following these days. So that is something that we would advocate that students do.
I would like to thank you, ma'am. Your views were really very helpful. Not only helpful for the VIT students, but as well as all other students who's going to see this video. And hope so they follow, we follow. And it will be really helpful for every career building. So thank you so much, ma'am, for for sharing your views with us.
Pleasure has been mine.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you.